Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, Form 2, lesson number 8. The topic it is Forms of Business Units. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at lesson objectives. Today we'll be looking at the formation of cooperatives, source of capital, and the management of cooperatives as the form of business unit. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain how the formation of cooperative is done. Where do they get state areas, their sources of capital, and also explain the management of the cooperatives formation. When we talk about the formation of the cooperative, it should be formed by people above 18 years. That means it is adults, regardless of their economic, political, or social background. Should not be less than 10. So one, they should be adults. Number two, that group should be not less than 10. So when we are talking about the group being above 18, no matter their economic level, no matter their political, and also their social background, we don't look at that, but a member is a member in a cooperative. The members draft rules and regulations called the bylaws to govern the operation of proposed society. So in cooperatives we have the bylaws. The bylaws are rules and regulations that are put forward or that are drafted by the members who start the business or who start the cooperative the first time. The bylaws are submitted to the commissioner of cooperatives for approval. So you need to present the bylaws to the commissioner of cooperative for the approval. So we cannot start without that. If the bylaws are accepted, the commissioner registers the society and issues a certificate of registration. So the bylaws, the acceptance, it is the one that is going to tell us, to tell the cooperative members whether they are going to get the certificate of registration or not. And the society can start its operation. After getting the certificate, now from there you can be able to start the operation. We go to management. Cooperative society is run by the committee of 9 members. Remember we said that it is democratic. By the members in general meeting, these were now the committee and selected by the members. They are selected, campaigning, and even voting is done by the cooperative members, and even the people who want to get the leadership. The management committee is going to get the chairperson, secretary, and treasurer as the executive members of the committee. So now after getting the management committee, the committee is now responsible to get the chairperson, the secretary, and the treasurer. And these are the ones that we are referring to them as the executive members of committee. The management committee does not receive monthly salaries, but are allowed a sitting allowance. What they get, it is the sitting allowance. You can be able to see their organization and management of cooperative, we are putting us together. We are bringing the whole world together. Not one, not two, but you are putting it together. Management is by use of a group, 9 members. If I thought it was started by 10 members, then it means the committee is only one person who is not involved. So it is members, a group of them. And even when it is organization, it is a group of them. They come up together. They get the bylaws. Then from there, they are going to start the business. Functions of the management committee. Holds regular meetings to transact business. So in case of any transaction, it is done by the management committee. Number two, enter into contracts on behalf of the members. So they are responsible now to get into contracts. They are working on behalf of the members. Number three, act on behalf of the other members of the society, like borrowing of money. In case they want to get advances, in case they want to get loans, they will do rate the management committee. Number four, looks for after the welfare of the members by providing education through seminars and general information. So they are responsible for offering advisory services. And even the education services, they ensure their members are getting it. When do these cooperatives get money? One, it is when their members contribute. So membership contribution is one of the source of their capital. Number two, retained profit. Repatriating the profit back again to the business. That is another source. Number three, income from credit facilities. When they get goods on credit and services on credit. Number three, income from investment. When now the cooperative start investing in other sectors. And number five, acquiring property on credits or on hire purchase. Types of cooperative societies in Kenya. In Kenya, cooperative societies are grouped according to the nature of their activities or according to their levels of operation. Nature of activity, what activity are they doing? Which level are they operating in? When grouped according to the nature of their activities, we get the producer cooperatives, consumer cooperatives, savings, and credit cooperatives. So you get the three of them. Producer cooperatives, consumer cooperatives, and saving and credit cooperatives. Where on the other hand, and on cooperative are classified as either primary cooperative or secondary or even tertiary cooperative. So it can be any levels of operation. Activity. Explain 5 principles under which cooperative society should be managed. Explain 5 principles under which cooperative societies should be managed. If I were told you want to get the refer, you can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If I told you want to contact us, you can get us through the SMS, you can also get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from the Facebook, and also you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.